Yeah. My sisters and brothers, we call to our God as we pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. It is great to be in the house of God, to call upon his holy name, and to be renewed and strengthened in what it means for us to be his children. Let us ask our God to hear us as we cry out to him, to strengthen us for the journey of faith that we make together. To our God, we cry out for mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us all, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, prayer, and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously on this confession of our lowliness, we pray, that we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us rid ourselves of every burden and sin that clings to us, and persevere in running the race that lies before us, while keeping our eyes fixed on Jesus, the leader and perfecter of faith. For the sake of the day, the joy that lay before him, Jesus endured the cross, despising its shame, and has taken his seat at the right of the throne of God. Consider how he endured such opposition from sinners in order that you may not grow weary and lose heart. The word of the Lord.
Merciful.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to listen to Jesus. But the Pharisees and scribes began to complain, saying, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." So to them Jesus addressed this parable. A man had two sons, and the younger son said to his father, "Father, give me the share of your estate that should come to me." So the father divided the property between them. After a few days, the younger son collected all his belongings and set off to a distant country, where he squandered his inheritance on a life of dissipation. When he had freely spent everything, a severe famine struck that country, and he found himself in dire need. So he hired himself out to one of the local citizens, who sent him to his farms to tend the swine. And he longed to eat his fill of the pods on which the swine fed, but nobody gave him any. And coming to his senses, he thought, "How many of my father's hired workers have more than enough food to eat? But here I am, dying from hunger. I shall get up and go to my father, and I shall say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son. Treat me as you would treat one of your hired workers.' So he got up and went back to his father. And while he was still a long way off, his father caught sight of him and was filled with compassion. He ran to his son, embraced him, and kissed him. The son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son.' But his father ordered his servants, 'Quickly, bring the finest robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Take the fattened calf and slaughter it. Then let us celebrate with a feast, because this son of mine was dead and has come to life again. He was lost and has been found.' Then the celebration began. Now the older son had been out in the field, and on his way back, he neared the house. He heard the sound of music and dancing. He called one of the servants and asked what this might mean. And the servant said to him, 'Your brother has returned, and your father has slaughtered the fattened calf because he has him back safe and sound.' He became angry and refused to enter the house. His father came out and pleaded with him. He said to his father in reply, 'Look, all these years I've served you, and not once did I disobey your orders. Yet you never gave me even a young goat to feast on with my friends. But when your son returns, who swallowed up your property with prostitutes, for him you slaughtered the fattened calf.' He said to him, 'My son, you are here with me always. Everything I have is yours. But now we must celebrate and rejoice, because your brother was dead and has come to life again. He was lost and has been found.'" My sisters and brothers in Christ, the gospel of the Lord.
Those that know me know I'm from the old school. And in the old school, you did everything father or sister told you to do. Isn't that right?
Yes.
Say, yes, Bishop.
Yes.
All right. So we're going to do an old school thing. We're going to all sing. And if you have a bad voice, God deserves to hear it, so he won't make that mistake again. Amen?
Amen?
Now, let me sing it through first, because there are many renditions of this song. So let me sing it through first, and then y'all come and join. I'll direct you to come in. Amen? If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God. If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God. Now I want everybody to sing. Now, some of y'all looking at me like y'all crazy, but I want everybody to sing. Amen? All right, ladies, stand up. Just the ladies. Let me just the ladies. Let me hear you, ladies. If anybody asks you, ooh, right, sit down. All right, guys, stand up. Y'all ready? Let's go.
If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God.
All right. Everybody stand up. Now, I want y'all to sing this song like y'all been singing this song all your life. All right? All right? Say yes, Bishop. All right, let's go.
If anybody asks me who I am, who I am, who I am,
my father is rich in houses and land. He holds the world in the palm of his hand. Rubies and diamonds, silver and gold. Just tell him I'm a child of God. Yeah.
If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God.
If you don't believe I've been redeemed, just follow me down to that old Jordan stream. I stepped in the water was cold, chilled my body, but not my soul, yeah.
If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God. If anybody asks you who I am, who I am, who I am, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God.
There's nothing like a church choir. Amen? But you know, let me tell you something. It's a secret, but I want y'all, I know y'all know this already. But there's, you know, some people think it's a secret. But every time we come into the house of the Lord, we should come ready and willing to participate in every prayer, every song, every ritual that goes on in church. When the church community gathers in that way, we come into the house of God expecting that God's going to do something for us that's going to make us change the way we are. So, you know, that's important for us to know because, you know, some people come into church crabby and they leave crabby. I'm not talking about people in California, but I know people like that across the country. It's important that we realize that when we stand on holy ground, we are standing on the shoulders of each other. We are here with each other. I got brothers and sisters praying with me, helping me, assisting me to be the child of God that I'm called to be in Christ Jesus. When we come to church that way, we cannot ignore one another. We have to support one another, strengthen each other, challenge each other to get in touch with God and what is the good news that he brings us. That word that is blessed and broken for us, the bread and wine that is blessed and broken for us, nourishing us, strengthening us to be better people when we leave this place. But y'all already know that, right? Say, yes, Bishop. Yes. You know, y'all got to talk back to me. We'll be here all night. So it's important that we do that and understand that. So we should come anticipating, okay, God, tell me something I don't know or something I should know a little bit better. And today, as we hear the word of God, we hear something I want us to focus on, that first reading, where the writer of the book of Hebrews is telling the community of believers, calling them to understand, even though you are persecuted and being trampled and everything is happening to you, understand that you are encompassed by the cloud of witnesses. You aren't in this by yourself. You are sharers in what it means for us to share what we mean and what we profess as believers in Jesus Christ. We are standing on the shoulders of many who have gone before us. And as we stand on their shoulders, we are called to recognize and affirm the faith we profess. As we come to tonight in this celebration, we are called to honor our ancestors. And I thought about that and I said, now, you know, I know they don't know what they're talking about. Because that means that we have to honor, as we reflect on this celebration, what it means for us to honor Black faith. Black faith. Because Black faith matters. And as we understand that, and I'm calling us to understand that tonight, I call us to understand it because I want you to know something. Our ancestors have been there and done that. And we carry on that tradition. And some people think we just come by lately, people. No, we've been there, y'all. Don't you let anybody deceive you. Understand that. So if you don't mind, before I go into my preaching, I got to go into some teaching. Because I know some of y'all are saying, well, what is he talking about? Isn't that right? Yes, Bishop, yeah. Well, first of all, in the scriptures, we know the stories. Did you know that one of the first women in the book of Genesis that God speaks to was a Black woman? And not only that, but she was a single parent. The story in Genesis tells the story about Hagar and her son Ishmael. Y'all know the story, right? Say, yes, Bishop. How many don't know that story? Lord, have mercy. Well, for those that don't know the story, I'm going to tell you the story. She says, I can't take this scene any longer, you know? And she leaves Sarah and Abraham and starts walking in the desert with her child. And her child starts crying. And she puts the child down on the ground and kind of walks away from it. And God comes to her and says to her, look, Hagar, I want pick up your child and go on back. And understand. And God gives to her this word. His descendants will be great. They will number the stars of the sky and the sands on the seashore. Sounds familiar, don't it? That's what God said to a black woman, a single parent, who was charged to live her life. Black faith matters. She believed God and went there. And then Abraham kicked her out, the king. And once again, she found herself in the desert with her child. And he cries again, and God says, Hagar, don't give up. I'm with you, and I'll take care of you and your son. And you know the rest of the story. Amen? Amen. If you don't, read Genesis 16 and Genesis 19. Amen? Amen. Don't just say I didn't tell you. And if that wasn't enough, then you have the story about Zipporah and Jethro, the wife of Moses and his father-in-law, where God tells the story tells the story about how they advised Moses how to deal with those people, those crazy people that came out of Egypt. You know? And Jethro says to his son-in-law, says, look, you know, you can't handle this by yourself. Appoint some judges. And he follows his direction. And they were able to survive through the journey. Then there's the story of one of my favorite stories about Ebed-Melech, the Cushite. Now, anytime, black folks, anytime you hear Cushite or Nubian in the scriptures, they're talking about us. It means dark face. Amen? Don't y'all say it, I didn't tell you. You should perk up. You're talking about us. But Ebed-Melech was one of the people, if you remember the story of Jeremiah, Jeremiah was telling the king, look, everybody in here is going to die because y'all did not follow God. You did not listen to God's directions, and so y'all going to all die. And so they kicked Jeremiah out and stick him in the cistern to die. And Ebed-Melech goes to the king and said, King, you know you're wrong. What you did to the prophet is not right. He will die for sure in that cistern. And the king said, go ahead and take him out. Ebed-Melech drew Jeremiah out of the cistern. And the beautiful thing in that story is this. God sends Jeremiah to Ebed-Melech. And he says to Ebed-Melech, because you trusted me and believed my word, you and your whole household will live. Black faith matters, y'all. Black faith matters. Then you have the beautiful story of the Queen of Sheba. She was the one that coined the phrase, I'm black and beautiful. Yeah, that came from scripture. Y'all think I'm lying? Look it up. Then there's the prophet Zechariah, the son of Cushi, who predicted the coming of the Messiah. And then there's the favorite ones, my favorite ones in the New Testament. First, there's Simon of Cyrene and his sons. You know, it wasn't by accident that a black man was chosen to carry the cross of Christ. You know that, right? You know. Now, I like to tell it as I understand it. See, I'm from New Orleans. You see, and I understand what it means to be in crowds at a celebration. You know. But listen, you know, it was Passover, right? Right? Okay, stay with me now. It was Passover, and here it is. Everybody was coming to Jerusalem. The streets were filled with people. I imagine it was like Mardi Gras in New Orleans, you know? And here, in the midst of all of this gathering of folks, the Roman soldiers come down the street parading three who are to go to Calvary and be crucified. And the Roman soldiers realize It was Passover. They could not choose a Jew to carry the cross of Christ. And so they turn and they see this black man, probably with his family, standing on the street, minding their own business, and says to him, "You, pick up that cross." And that black man at that moment had to make a decision to do that, or possibly he and his whole family would have been killed on the spot. A black man carried the cross of Christ, a person he did not even know. He carried a symbol of the death penalty of that time. And coming to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover, it meant that he could not participate because he was unclean. And if that wasn't enough, then you know the great story of the man, the Ethiopian eunuch. A man who was reading the scriptures, who tells and finds strength in the midst of his own humiliation as a eunuch from the story of this Christ that he's reading. Philip comes and explains it to him. He sees water, and you have the quickest baptism in the history of the Catholic Church. Black faith matters. Black faith matters. It is important that we understand we are surrounded by people who are not onlookers on us who are to give testimony by our lives, but they are there encouraging us, inspiring us to be true witnesses as they were. Black faith matters. And if that wasn't enough, that's just the scriptures. Let me go on with the saints. I'm just going to name a few. I'm not going to name them all because we'd be here all night. But I have to name some of them. Y'all don't mind, do you? Okay, good. I was going to do it anyway. There were three black popes. Pope St. Victor I, who was pope at the time when the church established what we know now as Holy Week and celebrate as Holy Week. Then there was Pope St. Galatius I, a son of a priest. Ain't that something? Who was pope who established at the time when we established the Roman Missal, the prayer book of the priests at Mass. And then Pope St. Matiliades, the pope who was pope at the time when the church became the church of the Roman Empire. And he was one who worked to develop and the promotion of the faith amidst all the schisms of his time. Black faith matters, y'all. Black faith matters. Y'all know the story of Monica and Augustine. I don't need to tell y'all about that. But do you know about Anthony of Egypt, the father of monasticism in northern Africa? Then my favorite saint, I got to tell you, my favorite saint is Moses the Black. Moses the Black was a big man. He was 6'6", my dream height. You know, a big man. He was a thief and marauder who fell into the hands of a group of hermits after one of his raids where he got hurt. And he was so impressed by the hospitality of these monks that he wound up joining the monastery, became a hermit, and later became the leader. And the sayings and some of the stories of the Desert Fathers of Africa tell the story of Abbot Moses. Abbot Moses wound up being a martyr who died for his faith. Then there's the story of another great saint of God, my Franciscan forebears. His name was Benedict the Black. Benedict the Black was just a simple man. He was a cook, and he loved to cook, but he was also one who was very generous to the poor. And he did everything he could to serve people and take care of the needs of all. He was so generous in his and his hospitable in his life and in his ministry that the friars appointed him novice director, superior of the house. He served in every kind of position someone can be as a friar. But he was a great saint who served his community and was a model of hospitality to everyone he met. Then there was Saint Thais, a prostitute, who went into the convent and committed herself to living and changing her life and wound up being a true symbol of holiness for everyone in the convent community. And the list goes on and on. We stand on the shoulders of some great people of faith. And it is our charge to continue to stand and move and be that for others that follow us. It is a necessary thing for us to understand that we are children of God. And as children of God, the best example of what we can do as believers is not just imitate God, but be a replica of God to others. Can we say that is true for you? I don't know about you, but that's what I'm struggling with each day of my life as I try to give testimony to the God who continuously showers his mercy upon me. I hope and I pray that as we honor our ancestors, that we understand that honoring them really can happen if we live up to being the kind of witnesses to Jesus Christ in our world today that we're called to be. Can we truly confess, not only in the words we speak, but in the way in which we live, that if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God. Sisters and brothers, may our every day and every moment focus be looking at the Christ who calls us to continue to witness his love in the world. May we have that strength, and may we profess that with confidence, making it our true confession as followers of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us turn to our God who hears every prayer.
That we uphold all that reassures the richness of our blackness and the fullness of our Catholicism, we pray.
Here
us, that we hold up the light of Christ against injustice, whether convenient or inconvenient. We pray. For resolve that we contemplate and raise up men to the priesthood and vowed religious life, we pray.
Hear us, Lord, hear us.
For tenacity that we envision and promote women to the consecrated life, we pray. For entitlement, that we claim each young person in our midst, always lifting them up to God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord, hear us.
For determination, that the youth and adults know and understand that now is the time, that they are the church of Jesus Christ today, every day, and never apologize for it. We pray.
Hear us, Lord, hear us.
For conviction, that we be righteous witnesses of our Black Catholic faith that breathes new life and spirit in our worship, we pray.
Hear us, Lord, hear us.
For confession, that we as inspired modern day Black Catholics keep working for the church we envision authentically Black and truly Catholic, and nothing less, we pray.
Hear us, Lord, hear us.
We know and pray to you, Most High God, that we have a charge to keep and you to glorify. May your Spirit of truth lead and guide us in the way of Jesus Christ, now and forever.
Thank you. Chastis family and St. Julian's family, Manuel Lovett, Quivette Powell Robinson, Rhonda Taylor Johnson, Effie Clark, and Evelyn Morris. Deacon Joe Battle. Joseph Mason, Virgie Aguilar, Maurice Simon, Nate Johnson, Laura Boyd, Tran Brewer. Oh, pray for us.
Pray for us.
Senior English, Norwood and Audrey Duplessis, Molly Wilson Murphy, Gail Munley, Gwen Hamillard, Saint Cyprian of Carthage.
Pray for us.
Sisters and brothers, that are offering our very lives will be acceptable to our God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice.
Through these sacred gifts, we pray, O Lord, may our redemption yield its fruits, restrain us from unruly desires, and lead us onward to the gifts of salvation through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundation of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race and who always walked with us on this journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and he breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. He gave you thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Oh,
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
Lord, renew your church by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people. Together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose fate you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, that in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
Let us now share a sign of peace with one another.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
God is good, the Lord is good, yeah.
let your faces not be abashed. This lonely one called, and the Lord heard, yes he did, and rescued her from all her distress.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. Jesus, they're forgiven.
Forgiven.
Now there are no more chains.
No more chains.
Because of God's love, there's no more fear.
Fear.
My past.
My past.
Oh, thank the Lord, it's over.
It's over.
Come on, say. And
today is the day
I've been changed.
I've been changed.
Can't go back
to the way it used to be
before
your presence.
Let us pray. As we receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. I'll tell them to bow their heads. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings.
In Christ, God has revealed his love and his truth. May he make you witnesses to the gospel and to divine love. Amen. The Lord Jesus promised to be with his church until the end of the world. May he give power to our actions and our work.
Amen.
And may the Spirit of the Lord be with you so that you may help the ministers of his word. Amen. Amen. And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
This celebration is over. Let us go forth in peace and joy to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.